Good evening, friends. Before we start the rosary, a gentle reminder about the Bible study. We have the Bible study from 5:30 to 6:30 p.m. every day during the season of Lent. We would encourage you to join the Bible study and also pass on the message to your friends and family. We will start the deliverance prayer. Keep the holy water with you and we can apply it on us as after we complete the deliverance prayer. Prayer of Deliverance by Pope Leo. In the name of Jesus Christ, our God and Lord, strengthened by the intercession of the Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of Blessed Saint Michael the Archangel, of Blessed Apostles Peter and Paul, and all the saints, we confidently undertake to repulse the attacks and deceits of the devil. God arises, his enemies are scattered, and those who hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so are they driven. As wax melts before the fire, so the wicked perish at the presence of God. Behold the cross of the Lord, flee bands of enemies. He has conquered the lion of the tribe of Judah, the offspring of David. May your mercy, Lord, descend upon us. As great as our hope in you, let us pray. We will make the sign of the cross as it appears on the screen. We drive you from us, whoever you may be. Every unclean spirit, all satanic powers, all infernal invaders, all wicked legions, assemblies and sects, in the name and by the power of our Lord Jesus Christ, may you be snatched away and driven from the church of God and from the souls made to the image and likeness of God and redeemed by the precious blood of the divine Lamb. Most cunning serpent, you shall no more dare to deceive human race, persecute the church, torment God's elect, and sift them as wheat. The Most High God commands you, he with whom in your great insolence you still claim to be equal, he who wants all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. God the Father commands you. God the Son commands you. God the Holy Spirit commands you. Christ, God's made flesh, commands you. He who to save our race, outdone through your envy, humbled himself, becoming obedient, even unto death. He who has built his church on the firm rock, and declared that gates of hell shall not prevail against her, because he dwell with her all days, even to the ends of the world. The sacred sign of the cross commands you, as does also the power of the mysteries of the Christian faith. The glorious Mother of God, the Virgin Mary, commands you. She who by her humility and from the first moment of her immaculate conception crushed your proud head, the faith of the holy apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all other apostles commands you. The blood of the martyr and the pious intercession of all the saints commands you. Thus, cursed dragon and you diabolic legions, we adjure you by the living God, by the true God, by the holy God, by the God who so loved the world that he gave up his only son, that every soul believing in him might not perish, but have life everlasting. Stop deceiving human creatures and pouring out to them the poison of eternal damnation. Stop harming the church and hindering her liberty. Begone Satan, inventor and master of all deceit, enemy of man's salvation. Give place to Christ in whom you have found none of your works. Give place to the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, acquired by Christ at the price of his blood. Stoop beneath the all-powerful hand of God. Tremble and flee when we invoke the holy and awesome name of Jesus. This name which causes hell to tremble. This name to which the virtues, powers, and dominations of heaven are humbly submissive. This name which cherubim and seraphim praise unceasingly repeating, holy, holy, holy is the Lord, the God of armies. O Lord, hear our prayer and let our cry come unto you. May the Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. God of heaven, God of earth, God of angels, God of archangels, God of patriarchs, God of prophets, God of apostles, God of martyrs, God of confessors, God of virgins, God who has power to give life after death and rest after work, because there is no other God than you, and there can be no other, for you are the creator of all things, visible and invisible, of whose reign there shall be no end. We humbly prostrate ourselves before your glorious majesty, and we beseech you to deliver us by your power from all the tyranny of the infernal spirits, from their snares, their lies, and their furious wickedness. Deign, O Lord, to grant us your powerful protection and to keep us safe and sound. We beseech you through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. From the snares of the devil, deliver us, O Lord, that your church may serve you in peace and liberty. We beseech you to hear us, that you may crush down all enemies of your church. We beseech you to hear us. Amen. Friends, let us sign ourselves with the holy water. Prayer to Saint Michael. Saint Michael, the archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all other evil spirits who prowl through the world seeking the ruins of souls. Amen. Mary, Queen of all saints, pray for us. Prayer to Saint Joseph. Hail, Guardian of the Redeemer, spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To you God entrusted his only Son. In you Mary placed her trust. With you Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen. Today, we focus on one of the most important principles in the kingdom of God, which is to operate in the virtue of forgiveness. Many people think forgiveness is an emotion, something you either feel or you don't feel. But that is not what it is. Forgiveness is an act of the will, a choice, a decision that we make. Forgiveness is choosing not to hold an offense against someone. Forgiveness is choosing not to dwell or continue to rehearse it in your thoughts. Forgiveness is choosing not to keep a record of wrong someone has done against you. Kingdom of God works in the principle of what we plant is what we reap. If we plant mercy, we will reap mercy. If we plant judgment, we will reap judgment. If we plant forgiveness, we will reap forgiveness. When we forgive someone, we redefine our role with the person who wounded us. Instead of reacting as a weak victim, we are making a godly decision as a follower of Jesus. The saints in the church have shown us how effectively they have practiced the virtue of forgiveness. Saint Ignatius of Loyola once walked 100 miles during the winter to nurse a man who had fallen ill. This man, few weeks earlier, had stolen Ignatius' meager savings. What an example of forgiveness that Saint Ignatius showed to us. A story happened in the life of Saint Philip of Zell. One night, two thieves stole the oxen that belonged to the hermit Saint Philip of Zell. But in trying to escape, they got lost in the woods. And at sunrise, to their great dismay, they found themselves back in front of Philip's hermitage. The saint emerged, knowing what has happened, and the confused and frightened thieves begged his forgiveness. Saint Philip welcomed and reassured them and let them go, but only after feeding them. These examples show true Christian forgiveness isn't meant to be only a religious concept, but a way of life. As Saint Augustine notes, there are many kind of alms, the giving of which helps us to obtain pardon for our sins, but none is greater than that by which we forgive from our heart a sin that someone has committed against us. Let us declare this word 7 times and thank God for rekindling the spirit of forgiveness that He has deposited in our hearts through the Holy Spirit and setting us free to live as a victorious Christian. Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. Jesus answered, I tell you, not 7 times, but 70 times 7. For all the intentions that has come to Missionaries of Prayer, the Holy Mass is offered every day by priests from different parts of our country. And today's Mass is offered by Father Pius Pereira. Let us pray very specially for Father Pius Pereira, for his ministry as a priest. He's also doing his PhD. Let Lord fill him with wisdom. The studies that he's doing may fulfill God's plan in his ministry. Today, we have 6 siblings, the Lobos siblings, who will be leading the rosary. They are Judith, Joshua, Naomi, Deborah, Hannah, and Abigail. Let us start. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead, and on the 3rd day He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father Almighty. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Do not lead us to temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen.
Holy Mary, daughter of the Eternal Father, strengthen our faith. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Holy Mary, Mother of the Beloved Son, increase our hope. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Holy Mary, radiant temple of the Holy Spirit, deepen our love. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The first glorious mystery, the resurrection. In this decade, we pray for marriages. Forgiveness is a form of love in action, and we cannot get far in marriage without it. When you love someone, you are vulnerable with them, and vice versa. Your spouse has the power to hurt you more deeply than anyone else in the world because you value his or her approval and affirmation more than anyone else. In the material world, often people equate forgiveness with weakness, and it is widely believed that if you forgive someone, you are condoning or excusing their behavior. However, in godly marriage, forgiveness is a strength because it shows you are capable of goodwill towards your partner. Forgiveness is about giving yourself and your partner the kind of future you and they deserve, unhampered by hurt and anger. It is a decision that you make for your sake and for the sake of your marriage. After Shahrukh's second delivery, she went through a time of depression. They call it post-pregnancy depression. During this phase, Shahrukh was behaving like someone with no feeling. She always walks around with a gloomy face. Most of the time, she used to sit in one corner and cry. Initially, I didn't know about these things, so I tried to advise her and cheer her up, but there was no use. More I tried, it was getting worse. So I took her to the doctor, but medicines did not work in her. I tried everything possible from my side to make her comfortable, but nothing was working out. Finally, I resorted to prayer, thinking that God will heal her. I was wrong. The more I prayed, worse she became. I started getting irritated and angry, and an unforgiveness started creeping into my heart towards her. I was not able to accept her as she was. Little did I realize that I was failing on the promise that I made on the day of our wedding, that in good times and in bad times, in health and sickness, that I will stand by her. Though physically I was with her, but mentally I was not. To cut the story short, not too late, God gave me the realization that I was at wrong and I need to change. I remember the day that I got this realization, I gathered courage to seek forgiveness from Shahrukh. That day she was sitting in a corner of the room with a gloomy face. I walked towards her and took her by my arms. Told her I will stand by her and I love her. I gave her a tight hug and a kiss on her face. That moment, the heavens opened and we both experienced a powerful anointing of God, which was a breakthrough in our lives. In few days, she was completely healed from depression. Forgiveness opens a torrent of grace in our lives. And now is the time to forgive your spouse. And God is inviting us to move into a life of victory. Let us thank the Lord for opening our hearts and setting us free from the bondage of unforgiveness, and for the grace to practice forgiving love with our spouse and other family members. Let us pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Do not lead us to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in the most need of your mercy. Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us.
The second glorious mystery, the Ascension. In this mystery, in this decade, let us pray for the families. Is it always easy to forgive others? Certainly not, especially when you are hurt by your own family members. Today, the biggest reason for the families to disintegrate is the unforgiving attitude between the family members. Anger is a powerful emotion, and even saints can be tempted by a desire for revenge. But they simply try harder to use the help God provides to overcome these feelings. Let us listen to these stories. Blessed Peter of Pisa was in the monastery when his father and brothers were murdered. He wanted to leave his monastery and avenge their deaths. But his sister, Blessed Claire, aided him in rising above this temptation. By fervent prayer and with the help of his sister's example, Blessed Peter arrived at the point where he could sincerely forgive the murderers. And even more dramatic conversion and act of mercy involved in St. John Gilbert. St. John's older brother, Hugh, was murdered by someone pretending to be a friend. John swore vengeance and one day encountered his unarmed enemy in a narrow passage that allowed no room for escape. Drawing his sword, John advanced, but was surprised when the murderer fell to his knees and crossed his arms on his breast. This posture reminded John of how Christ forgave his enemies while on the cross. Profoundly moved, John put away his sword, embraced his enemy, and left him in peace. It is said that John then went to a church to pray, and the image of Christ on the crucifix there miraculously bowed its head in recognition of John's sincere repentance and his act of forgiving his enemy. John Gilbert, like every other saint, before and after him, came to realize the absolute essential need to forgive our enemies. For Christ will reign only in a heart that seeks to be at peace. God's grace is available for us to overcome this bondage, and that is what the saints in the church teaches us through their lives. Mark 11:24 gives us the assurance, when you pray, believe that you've already received it and it will be yours. Today we thank the Lord for his mighty healing and deliverance for each one of us from unforgiveness. Let us pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Do not lead us to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of thy mercy.
The third glorious mystery, the descent of the Holy Spirit. In this mystery, we pray for the children. Reflecting the teachings of Jesus with children help them to understand and practice the virtue in their lives. Newsweek magazine carried a photo of three boys kneeling in a church pew. The story went on to say the boys' parents were killed when a bomb exploded on a plane over Colorado, killing 41 passengers. Children of St. Gabriel's, where the boys attended the school, asked if they could hold a prayer service for the boys' parents. The oldest boy said it would be okay. Then he added, "Could we also pray for the man who killed my parents?" Sometimes children put into practice the difficult teachings of Jesus far better than adults do. And sometimes God uses them to teach a lesson or two for struggling parents to overcome their vices. I wanted to share this personal experience. Initial days of lockdown was very hard for me to manage children at home. Having three super active boys, every day was like a war zone. Most of the time, I was losing my cool and getting angry at them. After every outburst, I used to feel so miserable. Every day morning, I wake up with a decision that I will not get angry with the children today. But by end of the day, I would have failed in that decision a couple of times. I was seriously thinking about it and wanted to get out of this habit of hurting my children. I prayed to God and kept telling him that I wanted to share his love with them and not my anger. One day, I came across a beautiful verse in the letter of James, chapter 1, verses 20, which reads like this. Man's anger does not bring about the righteousness of God. I started believing and declaring the power of this word in my life, especially in the area of anger and unforgiveness. Few days later, one evening, I was walking in the basement of my apartment. I was all alone, and I saw my son, Anthony, coming opposite to me from a distance. Anthony used to be the guy who was getting most of my bashing. The moment he saw me, he came running towards me and jumped onto me and gave me a tight hug. I really do not know what happened. I started crying profusely. I felt God enveloping me and his love started overflowing in my heart. I didn't want Anthony to see that I was crying. So I held his head so tightly to me. I believe that was God's answer to my prayer and the breakthrough that I was looking for. He gave me the grace to move from anger to agape love in dealing with my children. Ever since that experience, I have been steadily moving towards a life of victory in dealing with my children. Even though I have failed a few times, but quickly I have been able to get back and share the Father's real love with my children. Today is the day of breakthrough for all the struggling parents and children who is harboring anger and resentment in their lives. Let us thank God for bringing the healing power into our lives through his death on the cross. Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Do not lead us to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us.
The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of Mother Mary. In this decade, we will pray for the Church. We pray for Jerome Barnabas, Nikita Maria Puneet, and Teresa Mary Abraham for God's wisdom and guidance in their lives. It is not easy to forgive others, and also sometimes it is difficult for the other person to accept forgiveness from you for the wrong that he or she has done against you and break free from the guilt and shame. We all know the story of Blessed Sister Rani Maria. In 1995, Sister Rani Maria was stabbed by Samantha Singh over 50 times. Later, Singh was arrested and convicted for life term. During his stay in the jail, Singh was contemplating of killing those two people who motivated him to kill Sister Rani Maria and commit suicide. However, this plan was foiled by merciful act of Sister Rani Maria's family, who decided to forgive Samantha Singh and accept him as their own. It was not easy for Samantha Singh to accept the forgiveness from the family because he felt he didn't deserve it. After months of persuasion by Father Swami Sadanand, a Carmelite father, Singh decided to meet the sister of Blessed Rani Maria, who communicated to him that the family had completely forgiven for killing Sister Rani Maria. These days, a lot of priests and nuns are receiving criticism and abuse, not for the mistakes that they have committed. Let us pray that they may be strengthened to display the spirit of forgiveness and love of Jesus that died on the cross. Let us pray for this intention.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of your mercy. Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us.
The fifth decade, the coronation of Mother Mary. In this decade, we will pray for all the intentions of missionaries of prayer, especially the initiative of Bible study. We've been getting amazing feedbacks from the people who are participating in the Bible study, that they are able to learn the Word of God, understand the meaning, and practice that in their lives, and changing their heart and their character, and leading a victorious life. This is one of the biggest blessings that God can give into our lives, being a witness for Him in the place where we live. We wanted to especially thank all the participants who are participating in the Bible study, and thank especially Brother Johnson Secura for making himself available for us every day for 1 hour, discussing and sharing and clarifying making us understand the meaning of the word. Let us thank God for this great blessings that He has been showering in our lives. Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Do not lead us to temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in the most need of your mercy. Mary, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us. Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things, and I desire you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Closing prayer. Sweet Mother Mary, I offer thee this spiritual communion to bind a bouquet and a wreath to place upon thy brow. O my Mother, I come to you today with all the prayers and intentions of every brother and sister who prayed this most holy rosary today and lift their burdens along with mine to thee. Holy Mother of God, you have never turned away from your children who have sought your help and intercession. Look with favor upon our gifts, and in thy great love, obtain for us these graces. Amen. Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Christ have mercy. Christ have mercy. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Christ hear us. Christ graciously hear us. God the Father of heaven, have mercy on us. God the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy on us. God the Holy Spirit, have mercy on us. Holy Trinity, one God, have mercy on us. Holy Mary, pray for us. Holy Mother of God, pray for us. Holy Virgin of Virgins, pray for us. Mother of Christ,
pray for us.
Mother of Divine Grace,
pray for us.
Mother most pure, pray for us. Mother most chaste,
pray for us.
Mother inviolate, pray for us. Mother undefiled,
pray for us.
Mother most amiable,
pray for us.
Mother most admirable,
pray for us.
Mother of good counsel,
pray for us.
Mother of our Creator,
pray for us.
Mother of our Savior,
pray for us.
Mother of mercy,
pray for us.
Mother of hope,
pray for us.
Virgin most prudent,
pray for us.
Virgin most venerable,
pray for us.
Virgin most renowned,
pray for us.
Virgin most powerful,
pray for us.
Virgin most merciful,
pray for us.
Virgin most faithful,
pray for us.
Mirror of justice,
pray for us.
Seat of wisdom,
pray for us.
Cause of our joy,
pray for us.
Spiritual vessel,
pray for us.
Vessel of honor,
pray for us.
Singular vessel of devotion,
pray for us.
Mystical rose,
pray for us.
Tower of David,
pray for us.
Tower of ivory,
pray for us.
House of gold,
pray for us.
Ark of the covenant,
pray for us.
Gate of heaven,
pray for us.
Morning star,
pray for us.
Health of the sick,
pray for us.
Refuge of sinners,
pray for us.
Comforter of the afflicted,
pray for us.
Comfort of migrants,
pray for us.
Help of Christians,
pray for us.
Queen of angels,
pray for us.
Queen of patriarchs,
pray for us.
Queen of prophets,
pray for us.
Queen of apostles,
pray for us.
Queen of martyrs,
pray for us.
Queen of confessors,
pray for us.
Queen of virgins,
pray for us.
Queen of all saints,
pray for us.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us.
Queen assumed into heaven,
pray for us.
Queen of the most holy rosary,
pray for us.
Queen of peace,
pray for us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, spare us, O Lord. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, graciously hear us, O Lord. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, O Lord God, that we, thy servants, may enjoy perpetual health of mind and body, and by the glorious intercession of the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, be delivered from present sorrow and enjoy eternal happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. We would like to thank the Lobo siblings for beautifully leading the rosary. Their parents, Naveen and Ginny, are full-time missionaries with the Santuna community. They have been a blessing for many families across the country, they are also one of the pioneers for Catholic homeschooling in India. We pray that God may use them more for His glory and His work on earth. Now let us bow down for the priestly blessing.
Let us pray. God, the giver of life, give us the grace to resolve our problems. Give us the grace what is pleasing to you, which is confirmed by your presence in our life. Give us the grace to understand your teaching and bestow on us all the favors that we stand in need of. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. May Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.